Okay, I am going to unbox again the Sony A7II. Basically, I already unboxed it at the shop. I just sell my Nikon D800E to my friend with the SB900 around $1,000. And I got this camera with an extra battery, and they give me the kitlens. The kitlens not in the box because someone buy the A7III and they sell it back to the shop, and I get this with the compliment of buying the A7II. The price is almost the same, which is $1,000 and $20 extra from that. So I think it's okay for me for startup. I love the Nikon D800E, but I had to make a move to the Sony because I am going to make some of video, because the Sony you can shoot at the higher bit rate and better quality of the video, and also the S-lock. Okay, let's unbox what's inside. What I got with the $1,000 at my country, Malaysia. Okay, basically they give me one extra battery. They say it is original, but I'm not sure is original or not. And they give me 16 gig, but I didn't use this card because I already have like 64 gigs USH1, which I take from my D800E. And this is the manual books, which you might not interested. Maybe not many people read this, and I think most of us just skip this part. Let's see, it's colorful. This stated the like a user manual, something, the adapter stuff. Okay, put that beside. Let's open the box. Okay, what we have here is the camera inside the packaging. I'm sorry because I'm using the webcam, the quality is very bad. Maybe I have to change the new webcam. Too bad the recording button is on this side. Never mind, let's see what's inside the box. This I have the straps, the A7 straps. Doesn't state the A7II or 7. And what else do I have here? The battery. The adapter for the charging. Charging adapter to the body. The shopkeeper said I don't have the external charging. The cable. Much more cable. I think this cable used at Hong Kong or not at my country. I'm not sure it's Hong Kong because I never went to Hong Kong. Yeah, this the plug which I use at my country. If you are visiting Malaysia, this the plug and play. I have the plug, so I keep it everything inside the box pack. Okay, the strap, take it. Yeah, the extra battery. Previously, I have the A6000, and my friend immersed it into the water, seawater, and everything was damaged and cannot be repaired. the shopkeeper, the service Sony service center told me if I could not repair and I can get like 20% off discount if I ask them to make a appeal letter if my item cannot be repaired or damaged or I want to buy a new one. Okay, glossy everything. Just take the camera out. Okay. The extra battery. No, this is not battery. This is a adapter for the charging. I bet. Oh, it's a bit different compared to the A7II over there. Yeah. Maybe just keep it here first. The memory card, maybe I will keep in my memory card space. Or I have a small box to keep all the memory cards. Okay, I think that's all. I think it's the battery. Put it inside the box. I think all the rubbish stuff. Yeah. Okay. Put there. Close this. Okay, that's nice. So this is my first mirrorless. The A6000 was previously my friend, he gave to me. And this is my first Sony camera, which I bought using my money that I sold my Nikon D800E. I love the Nikon D800E. It have a very huge megapixel. But I have to make a jump to the Sony because of the video. Also, I am shooting at the live. I using the live mode at the A100A, which is very slow. So I think the live view mode at the Sony is much better. And also, yeah, I love the megapixel, but sometimes it's too much. Sometimes it's okay. When I travel, I like the huge megapixel whereby I can crop there, crop here. But I shoot at the raw lossless uncompressed, which is around 70 to 80 megabyte per raw picture. Less than 2 months or 3 months, I finish up my 1 terabyte hard disk. So I also have to make the jump. So it to my friend, I hope she will take care of my D800E. Okay, let's see the lens. Okay, like I said before, this lens was from the A7 Mark III. Someone buy only the camera and sell the lens. So, this is the hood. Okay, let's open this. Okay, and let's put inside this. Yep. Actually, I was thinking to buy the 28 prime, but I have not enough money, so I buy this lens. At least I can shoot at a wide open of 3.5. The lens is not so heavy, but actually I really like the zoom lens. Normally at the 800E, I just use the 50mm art lens. But nowadays, I shoot more weddings, so I need a bit wide lens, and I can go to 70, I think. I think that's all for the lens. I cannot shoot at the low ISO in the room. Sometimes I feel a bit regret, but it's no way to get back to Nikon because I have to make a video because right now many of my clients asking if I doing the video. Yeah, I can shoot the video at my D800E, but the quality is not as good as a higher megabit of the Sony. Okay, let's put the lens. Okay. Sorry. Why? Okay. And the battery. Yeah, at least it's better than A6000 where the memory card is, slot is at the battery compartment. We cannot go in. Oh, my mistake. Okay, go. So now using the this memory card, Extreme Pro 64GB. Sorry, the my webcam cannot be autofocus. One slot memory card for the 2018. In 2018, you only have one memory card. Seriously, it's okay. I shoot more portraits. I hope the memory card is okay for like I shoot the photo in since 2010. I used the Nikon D90 that time, and then I changed to the D810 and D800E, and now I move to the Sony. Mirrorless is very small compared, but if you use the big lens, the professional lens, the weight is almost similar to the other camera. What else should it's certified by Malaysia company. What, seriously? You got like the logo here, you cannot see properly. Okay, I think I need to buy a new webcam for the better resolution. What? Cannot be turned on? Oh no. Okay, never mind. Let me try with another battery. I have another battery. Let's see what's different between this battery. Never mind. That's right. Hopefully it won't jam my camera. It cannot be turned on. No battery. Yeah, no battery, need to charge it first. Okay, I cannot show you the settings. Not the setting, I mean, I think if you are a Sony user, you should know that this can shoot at the AVCS format, AVSC format, something like that, and with the 28 or 50 megabits bitrate. The higher the bitrate is better the higher quality. Sometimes it's too much, timorous. Sometimes it's too much, but I like the quality, even this 1080p. I think that's all for this video, so maybe I will upload the image sample or video sample in the future.